First things first, as usual, credit where credit is due. Thank you to Words at Scale for showing me this pretty interesting method. What I basically did was take his prompt, and I think I made it even better. But thank you to Words at Scale for showing me this amazing prompt. So how does this work? This is a new ChatGPT prompt. It works best in the Playground, OpenAI Playground. If you do not have access to this Playground, I'm going to leave this link in the description. People have been telling me that this gives you access to ChatGPT 4. If you still don't have access, the way that you have to get access is you have to use 3.5 and you have to be billed for your usage of 3.5. Once they know that you're a reliable user of their service and that you will always pay, then they will upgrade you to ChatGPT 4. However, how does this prompt work? This is a super, super interesting prompt, and it works in a very unique way. So what I basically did, I added a few things. So always write in Markdown, start with a title for the entire article, and each article should start with an H2 header. Do not give each article a conclusion, but instead write one overall article with each new article being an H2. When writing the questions, think about the outline for an article and try to make the outline make sense for one long form article. So I added this part basically. But how does this actually work? So step one, generate 10 of the most asked questions from people about black tie attire for men. If you want, you can add things like make sure to think about SEO, make sure to use the most popular things, etc., etc. And then what it does, I changed this to 10 paragraphs instead of 1,000 words because ChatGPT does not work very well with words. Step two is to take the first question from the list from step one and write a 10 paragraph article using Markdown formatting, lists and tables where applicable. And then it just repeats that over and over and over. And the end result is actually surprisingly good. So we could leave this on 3.5, but I'm going to put this on 4 just because I personally prefer 4. But yeah, you can actually leave it on 3.5. Temperature, set it nice and low. You don't have to put it too high. And then what we can also do is we could add a little something here, which is also try to include my internal links at least once in the entire article. Never use the same internal link more than once. I'm adding this right now, so if it doesn't work, we might have to fiddle around with it a little bit, but basically we're going to add this designer's kit on. The reason I like to do this is for two reasons. Basically, number one is because internal linking is important, but number two, it gives more context for ChatGPT to actually create the article. So we'll place that with that, and then we're going to say execute steps 1 to 11, and then we're going to hit submit. And what this is actually going to do is it's going to give us an H1 title. It's going to give us each question one by one with a large answer. And what this does is it creates a really, really long form answer, which if you're looking for long form content, this is probably the best way to do it currently. This also does a few different things. So first of all, it writes nice long content, but it also tends to do, for example, a list like it is right now. So it's telling you to check the event requirements, personal style, body type, all that stuff in a nice list that is really, really good for ranking on Google. So for me personally, this is a really, really good way to do it. I am looking for a table, but it's decided not to make a table just yet. It should make a table, and I'm going to show you a little trick to add a bit more content to this at the end if there is no table in this. But for now, we'll just see what this does, and we'll see how this content looks at the end. Okay, so that seems to be done. What we're going to do now is, as usual, we're going to go to markdown2html.com, and we're going to control A, link A, and then control V. And this is only part of the content, so we're going to scroll up as well and get this part of the content as well. The good thing about markdown2html is it's actually super, super easy to edit. So what we're looking for is it says shirt here. So we need to get rid of this, press enter twice, and then control V. Okay, so that looks like it's a completed article right here. So let's have a look and see how many words it actually wrote. So we'll do word counter. Just use any random word counting tool, it doesn't really matter. Oops. 1,500 words. So that's pretty good for a ChatGPT completion, as probably quite a lot of you know. But we can try writing continue here because I'm not sure if it actually hit all of the, it didn't. So there is still more content to come. Okay, so that should be the content completely done now. So we'll go down to the bottom of markdown2html, hit enter twice, control V. you can see it added a bit more content. But now what we want to do is we want to say, can you create a table summarizing the information in the article? And then under, please add FAQ with followed by FAQ page schema. And then we'll hit submit again. Hopefully this won't be too long. Okay, perfect. So what this does is it should make a little table summarizing all the information. What that does is a couple of things. Number one, it makes it easier to rank on Google because it's more content. Number two is it basically keeps people on the page for longer because they have something that will immediately grab their interest, okay? It's super, super important to have something on the page that will grab their interest, keep them on the page, keep them reading, etc., because that increases the amount of time on page, which is one of the biggest ranking factors that Google currently uses. The reason I know that is because Google and YouTube actually use very, very similar algorithms. So I'm just going to press cancel here because I actually want FAQ content in H2 followed by FAQ page schema. Submit. Yeah, so that's going to do that now. And then we'll put everything together. So what I really like about this method is it uses logical SEO instead of like keyword driven SEO. And what does that mean? It means you're trusting ChatGPT to ask the right questions, okay? And although that's not going to work 100% of the time, sometimes it will, you know, mess up with a keyword or whatever. Generally speaking, the questions that it has here are the people also ask questions on Google. And the reason for that is just because that's how SEO works, okay? SEO is just the most popular questions that you can think of about a topic put onto a web page, okay? So that's why this actually works so damn well. The final thing we're going to do is just put everything together, and then we can instantly just put it into whatever CMS we're working with. So first of all, we will grab the table from before. So we'll copy this, and we'll put the table right at the top. So under what is black tie attire for men. Perfect. Now we have internal links as well, which is super, super nice. As you can see, this is a great way to write quick content. And then finally, we're going to put the FAQs at the bottom like this. And we'll get rid of those three dots. And there should be another set of three dots that we do not need. Okay, perfect. And then, yeah, that is everything. So now let's go on word counter and we'll see how many words we have in total. 2,781 words. And I would say that was a great success. So this is something that I'm currently looking at. People always ask me what is the best prompt right now, but it changes, okay? It depends what you're doing, et cetera, et cetera. To write informational long form content, this is probably the best prompt that I have right now. You'll find the prompt in the description as usual. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you very, very soon with some more content. Peace out.